Updated on a story we first brought to you as breaking news on Sunrise. The State Patrol is investigating a crash involving a Lakeville police squad car. Around 10 last night, the squad and another car collided at Cedar Avenue and 205th Street. Police tell us the squad didn't have its lights or sirens on and wasn't responding to a call. A person in the other car, who we now know was not wearing a seatbelt, was brought to the hospital with serious injuries. Well, at the state capitol, it could be a scramble as we near the end of the session. Some lawmakers are still pushing to get major bills passed. I know Michelle has been working on this story all week. What can you tell us for an update?
Yeah, Cece, the latest, the House and Senate are in session as we speak. Here is a live look over the House floor. Already discussions over the ERA, Republicans supporting an amendment to that. So let's get into the Equal Rights Amendment after it's been twice tabled this week. Remember, just 24 hours ago, we told you how Republicans voiced their outrage when the House Speaker ended their hours-long debate on another bill. Regarding the ERA, the Speaker said she's ready to shut down a filibuster, though she thinks a debate up to 6 hours would be fitting. The Democrat-backed ERA would create a path to add protections like abortion and gender expression to the state constitution. Republicans have vowed, though, if the Dems move forward on the ERA, they will not be supporting a bonding bill.
It is not equal rights. It is actually very divisive. It does not protect women. It does not protect our public spaces. There is no provision for age. It enshrines the most extreme abortion rights that are already legal in Minnesota. It enshrines those.
If Republicans are conditioning their support for a bonding bill on denying civil rights to trans Minnesotans, then we won't have a bonding bill.
There's certainly a lot more to follow as the deadline Sunday night at 11:59 gets closer, Cece.
Yeah, a lot still on the table there. Thanks, Michelle. Well, just a few hours ago, the Minnesota GOP convention kicked off at the St. Paul River Center. That means right now, party leaders are meeting to discuss how they plan to move forward in upcoming elections. As part of the day's events, former President Donald Trump will be making a stop in the state to speak at the Lincoln-Reagan dinner tonight. We have more on the governor's reaction to the visit later in the newscast. Well, contempt proceedings against Attorney General Merrick Garland are moving forward after two House committee votes last night. It comes after President Biden called on executive privilege to stop audio recordings from being released in a congressional subpoena. But one of the biggest stories from the night is how representatives interacted during that vote. Here's one part of an interaction between representatives.
Talking about, I guess
I think your fake eyelashes are messing up.
No,
with your
ain't nothing.
Hold on.
That is absolutely unacceptable. How dare you attack the physical appearance of another person?
Are your feelings hurt?
Her words down.
Aww.
Oh, girl, baby girl.
Oh, really?
Don't even play.
Yeah, things definitely getting heated there. But back to the actual vote, it now opens the door for the full House to vote on holding the Attorney General in contempt. This afternoon, we know at least 4 people have died following powerful storms across the southern part of the country overnight. The Weather Prediction Center says Texas saw rare levels of rain, leading to significant flooding. Powerful winds also added to the danger. In Houston, a building partially collapsed. Today, Louisiana and Mississippi are also dealing with flooded roads. Back home, new data shows less building permits are being pulled in the Twin Cities metro. Here's a look at why that could cause big problems for renters.
I'm Jennifer Hoff. The rental housing market is in such a slump, rent prices may very well go up. Data shows a record low. 6 permits were pulled in March for multifamily homes, compared to nearly 990 2 years ago. Economists say a steady supply of housing does put downward pressure on the entire market, and that can prevent rents from rising. There are also other factors preventing developers from investing in new projects right now, including high interest rates, labor shortages, and a need for single-family homes.
If you plan to be in the St. Paul area and are free right now, you can have lunch with Mayor Melvin Carter at Mears Park.
If you're a Democrat, come have lunch. If you're a Republican, come have lunch. If you agree with me, come have lunch. If you disagree with me, come have lunch. If you are my same or age or a different age, if you live in my neighborhood or a different neighborhood, whatever it is, let's just get together and show that people from different walks of life can have a meal together and enjoy each other's company.
The park will have food trucks, activities, and a conversation with city leaders. Over in Minneapolis, the farmers market is open for business, and it's incredible that this is their 148th year. But there are some changes, including a shift to a Wednesday through Sunday schedule. I had a chance to visit some vendors to see what's in season. Hey there, we're here at the Minneapolis Farmers Market, a tradition that's really been here in the city for almost 150 years. We wanted to stop by and, you know, check out what's to offer here now that summer is right around the corner. Here to talk a little bit more about that, I'm here with Executive Director Ashley Nathy. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for coming.
All right, so what can people expect when they come on down here?
So when you come on down here right now, we've got a lot of different gardening plants. We've got a lot of starter plants. We've got hanging baskets, herbs, asparagus, rhubarb, and you'll see a program throughout the season.
Great, and how many vendors can people expect to run into?
Probably on the weekends we'll have between 60 and 70 vendors, and it'll continue to grow from there. During the weekdays, it's a more intimate market, so it can range during the weekdays.
Yeah, and I know that you're saying before this that it can be really interactive with cooking and things like that.
Yeah, we're really excited about the cooking demonstrations that we're going to have all season long. Chef Laura Bonicelli is going to show us how to shop the market and preserve our farmers market hall.
We also have run into a vendor. We made a new friend here. Hi, Margaret. Thanks for being here.
Well, I'm happy to be here. We got lots of exciting things for people to pick out here and find. A lot of vegetable plants, herb plants.
Tell us a little bit about how people come here to really just shop around and how they're really loving your stand.
Well, we try to have a variety. We're full-time farmers, so we start out with all the bedding plants in the spring, and then as the season progresses and more veggies come in, we have a whole line of fresh produce, everything from asparagus to zucchini and sweet corn and everything else in between. So we're busy, busy.
Perfect. Thank you so much for talking about your stand. My photographer was saying that we can't leave this area without buying at least something, so we're going to be here for a little bit longer. No, I had such a great time there. Here's a look at the new hours for the market. You can stop by as early as 6 a.m. tomorrow. The summer season runs through October. It's so fun there, and you can never not have a good time at the
exactly.
farmer's market.
I just want to go there for Margaret. I just want to hang out with Margaret and go shopping with Margaret.
Awesome. And yeah. Well, today.